Tonight, we continue our series of interviews with candidates in this year's election for city council. Our guest is a candidate from Dorchester who's one of the finalists running for re-election as councilor at large. We'd like to welcome Anissa Asabi-George. Thank you very much for being with us, councilor.
Oh, no, thank you for the invitation.
Because I want to start with housing issues because everybody's talking about them. And you just introduced something recently to have part of that problem looked at more closely. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so all of us are talking about housing. We recognize across the city of Boston that housing is a tremendous issue. It's at a crisis point for many of our families and residents across the city. So every candidate, every councilor running for re-election, every elected official and policymaker has been focused on the issue of housing because it is critical for our city to make sure that we have access to affordable housing. You know that I chair the council's committee on homelessness, mental health, and recovery, and since taking office in 2016, I've been focused on families experiencing homelessness. I've been meeting over the last 2.5 years or so with family shelter providers that work with our families in the city of Boston. There's been about 60 of them coming to the table almost every month. And I've leveraged my role as a city councilor, as chair of this committee, to connect them with policymakers at the state level and at the city level to really support families experiencing homelessness. Yesterday at the city council hearing, we shifted that work from talk to action. I've called for the formation of a special commission to end family homelessness in the city of Boston. And the root response to the needs of families experiencing homelessness has to be housing.
Well, one thing we're hearing in the race for council right now, both at large and in the districts, is practically a debate about going back to rent control. Mm-hmm. Should Boston be at least taking steps in that direction?
We need to be doing lots of different things in the city of Boston to create better access to affordable housing. My time on the council, I've called for an increase in the percentage of affordable units. We're working to make sure that affordable units are more affordable as we work with the AMI percentage breakdown of any large-scale development that has a percentage of affordable housing. It's right now at 13%. We'd like affordable percentages to be at 20. I'd like AMI to move down to 30 and 40%. So some of our families who are experiencing the greatest difficulty accessing housing can afford housing. I've been working with the Boston Housing Authority and helping them create access to more units across our city. We have currently a tremendously long wait list, 48,000 families waiting for housing through the Boston Housing Authority, and we're only housing about 800 families a year. When I think about my work around supporting our families experiencing homelessness, that's some of the work that I've been doing. I am opposed to rent control. I do not think that it's a tool that we should be using in the city. There are so many other things that we need to be focused on. Rent control, unfortunately, brings with it a divestment in housing stock in the city of Boston. There will be no new housing built, especially for families. When we think about the most vulnerable population and the housing that's the most difficult to build, it's family housing. We also will see, I think, a really unfair burden placed on small homeowners that are maybe using that second unit, or if they own a three family, to support their family. It's a very unfair burden that will be placed on them.
As you know, we have a lot of new high-rise luxury units, and some people say we ought to tax them a bit more for flipping. What do you think about that?
Yeah, no, I support that. And Councilor Edwards, as a member of our body, has really led that discussion, especially as chair of the Committee on Housing for the City Council, and creating and being creative about the ways in which we can add to our affordable housing funds. And we need to think creatively, and it's the luxury units, the investor units, especially investors that are nowhere to be found in our city. We need to put pressure on those components of our housing market to make sure that we're able to create more affordable housing, working class, middle income housing, and extremely low income housing. For the families that I work with and the providers that I support, that is a huge missing piece when we think about housing in the city of Boston. It's the extremely low income piece, as well as that middle sort of working class. And our families experiencing homelessness are working families. There's just very little access to some of these affordable units and truly affordable units across the city.
This is BNN News. We're talking with Anissa Asabi-George, candidate for re-election as city councilor at large. Councilor, another issue you've worked on a lot is the opioids crisis. The mayor's mid to long-term plan is to rebuild the Long Island Bridge and restore the services on the island. But there's another candidate out there saying that maybe instead of spending all that money on the bridge, maybe we should spend money now on service is to take care of the problems that were clustered around Mass and Cass.
Yeah, no, there are certainly challenges clustered around the Mass and Cass area, but we see the opioid crisis touching every neighborhood in the city of Boston. And what we see at Mass and Cass is troubling, and we have doubled down most recently with an influx of some money from our state partners. The Boston delegation has worked very hard to make sure that we're getting the financial resources we need to support individuals who are truly struggling with addiction and dealing with substance use disorders every single day in our city. That work will continue, needs to continue, but we also have to work to rebuild that Long Island Bridge. Through my work as chair of the Committee on Homelessness, Mental Health, and Recovery, I've done a tremendous amount of work around the systems and fixing the systems that are broken to help individuals access longer-term recovery. And I know in our state we need about 2,500 longer-term recovery beds made available so individuals who are in crisis can find a lifetime of recovery that works for them. Long Island will present an opportunity for hundreds of beds, and that benefits our city's residents, and that benefits people in the region, because we know that more than half of the individuals who come to the city of Boston looking for help and are also dealing with substance use disorders are coming from other communities. So this is about Boston responding, but it's really about a regional response to the crisis of addiction, the crisis of homelessness, the crisis of poverty, lack of economic opportunity, lack of mental health services. We need to do both at the same time. A very intensive outreach and connection of services to individuals today while we're working to rebuild the Long Island Bridge and continue services on that island in the long run.
I want to ask you about the national test scores that came out about the Boston Public Schools. There seems to be a trend here in recent years, at least, of things going downhill, racial divides in terms of achievement. What do you think should be done about that?
Well, as chair of the Council's Committee on Education and former high school teacher and proud parent of four BPS kids, our school district is doing some wonderful things, but we continue to see certain problems persist across the district. And we think about access to academically or rigorous academic programs across our district. It's something that we continue to strive for, but it's so difficult to help our kids find that excellence in school when they continue to deal with the lack of resources that can really support them in that effort. I've worked to make sure that we have a full-time nurse in all of our buildings, and I know nurses provide such an immediate level of support for our kids who are experiencing trauma, but we need more than that. We need mental health providers and behavioral health specialists in our classrooms. I'll continue to work on that in the new year, because as we support our kids with these extra pieces, they then can fully achieve academically in the classroom. And teachers can be left to do that work of helping our kids learn and explore and grow as students.
Thank you very much for being with us.
No, thank you.
City Councilor Anissa Esaibe-George. Still to come, the rules for short-term rentals in Boston, what homeowners and neighbors need to know. But first, this message.